हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड इवनिंग, वेलकम टू ऑल। ऑडिबल, विजिबल, राइट। सो विल फाइंड अनदर 2 मिनट्स बिफोर वी स्टार्ट। सो टुडे सेशन स्पेसिफिकली वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एसएससी सीजीएलई टीयर 2 क्वांट, दैट इज योर पेपर 1, क्वांटिटेटिव एबिलिटीज प्रिपरेशन। Right. We'll also have one more session maybe 2 weeks down the lane. SSC CGLE paper 2 preparation, that is your English language. Right, friends. So we'll start in a couple of minutes. Hope all of you can see me. I'm audible. Am I audible? Good evening, Mahima. We'll start off in some time. People are joining. Just now, it's 7 o'clock. So maybe every 10-15 minutes I'll take up the questions. If you have any questions, you can post, we'll take it up. Yes sir, you are audible. Vichitta Paul, good evening sir. Dinesh, hi Dinesh, good evening. Good evening sir. Apurva, good evening. Momita Das, good evening. Right. Then we'll start off. So maybe about 1 hour session today. Any queries you have in between, you can just post your queries. We'll take it up. The broad idea is like, this is for students who are going to write SSC CGLE Tier 2. Maybe you're not writing Tier 2 in the upcoming months. Yogi is saying good evening, hi. Pratoti Mitra saying good evening, hi. Alina saying good evening, hi. Right. So the point is, what I'm trying to tell you is, even though you have not written this SSC Tier 1 this year and you are not writing Tier 2 also, don't worry. Maybe next year you'll be writing this Tier 1 and Tier 2 exam. This, whatever points I'm trying to tell you, this will help you for your preparation. Now the broad idea is, we will see what is the breakup, what are the different question types asked, and what one should do as a part of your preparation. So SSC CGLE is, your, all of you know that Group B and Group C posts. You know, central government organizations, socially influential and very very lucrative posts. So definitely, maybe you're preparing for bank coaching now, whatever SSC notification is, maybe in the tier 1 notification coming up, definitely I think most of you will be right, because almost 70% of the syllabus is common, and central government jobs is a big thing to get into, right? So I'm discussing tier 2 quant paper today. So you just make a note, it will be helpful for you when you're writing your SSC tier 2. Anybody is writing SSC tier 2 this time? Yes, very, very helpful. Next time also, definitely helpful. This will give you a broad idea about your preparation. Right, students, we'll start off. So we'll discuss topic-wise breakup of last few years. What are the different question types asked? What are the preparation tips for SSC tier 2? And exam strategy. So what should be your exam strategy while writing this paper? So what strategy should you, what you call, implement? We'll discuss broadly 2 strategies, whichever is applicable to you, whichever you feel comfortable, you can apply that particular strategy. Now SSC CGLE paper 1, quantitative abilities, 100 questions, 200 marks, each question carry 2 marks, and duration is 2 hours, and as you know, 1/4 is the negative mark. Let us look at topic wise breakup. Just look at these points. Right? Don't buy heart this topic wise breakup. Anyways, we'll upload this on our channel, this complete presentation. You don't worry about this. Let us look at this. Simple equations. If you observe here, I've given breakup of 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Last 5 years, you can see here 2 to 3 questions, 0 to 2, 2, no questions asked, 2 questions here. Ratio 3 to 4, 6, 6, 3, 4. So I can say about 3 to 6 questions from your ratio. You just focus on these topics: percentages, profit loss, partnership, market price, discount. Just look at these numbers. Very, 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 very important topic. Just yet, very important topic. Why I'm writing this? You add this, right? 10, 13 plus 2, 15, 12 questions. 12 plus 4, 16 questions. 12 plus 2, 14 questions. 7, 11, 14, 16. I can say percentages, profit loss, partnership. This particular topic, you can expect about 14 to 16 questions. Very, very important topic. And very easy topic to deal with. Then, simple interest, compound interest. You can see here, 4 questions from this topic. Averages. Earlier used to be 4 to 5, but if you observe last year, there were 2 questions. Mixed asset allocation, I can say about 2 questions last year. Before that, also there are 2 questions. Not 2 questions, 4 questions, 3 to 4 questions, all these are important topics. But I'm saying, look at it, these are very, very important topics. One is percentages, profit loss, partnership. This is one such topic, right? Then, time and distance here. Earlier, we never had these questions from direct time and distance questions. Direct time and distance questions, we had about 3 questions in last 2 years. But earlier, there used to be average speed questions. Last 2 years, there were no average speed questions. Trains, yes. Now and then, one question from trains and boats and streams. You can expect 1 question to 2 questions. So time and distance, time and work together. This complete slide is time and work, time and work, time and distance, right? So average speed, we'll discuss under time and distance. Trains, we'll discuss under time and distance. Boats and streams is a subtopic of time and distance. Linear races is a subtopic of time and distance. Time and work, wages, pipes and systems. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 5, 7. So direct time and work questions, there are questions on wages, there are questions on pipes and systems. Progressions, on and off, you can expect about 1 to 2 questions. But in one of the slots in 2017, there were about 4 questions from progressions. Quadratic equations, not generally asked in 14, 15. There were about 1 question minimum and 5 questions in 17. 2018, no questions from quadratic equations. So I can see important topic, but not many questions, as you can see, like your percentage, profit loss, or TWDD, time and work, time and distance. Now, this is a very important slide. Just yesterday's numbers. Very, very, these are all very important topics. From here to here, very important topics. Right? Numbers here, last 2 years, 9 to 10, 7 to 12 questions. Geometry. 12 to 13, 10 to 12. Mensuration last 2 years, 12 to 13, 13 to 15. Before that, maybe 2014, 15, 16, I have not bifurcated separately, but if you can see 28, 26, 24, here also if you add, it's minimum 23 to maximum 27, 24 to 26. That means I can say 24 to 27 questions. That means 1/4 of the questions, right? Total paper is of 100 questions, right? 25 questions are more than 25 questions from geometry and mensuration. That means almost 25% of the questions are from geometry and mensuration. Very, very important topic for SSC CGLE tier 2 as well as for tier 1 also. But tier 1, we have only 25 questions. This is a separate paper of 100 questions. Now, indices search, you see 3 to 4, 2 to 6, about 3 to 4, or I can say 3 to 6 questions. Trigonometry, this is one such topic. This is one more topic. This is called higher maths, or you can call it as pure maths. Trigonometry, algebra, coordinate geometry. Agar aap higher maths bol sakte ho, yeah, pure maths bol sakte ho. 10, 10, 10, 10, 11 questions. Algebra, 4, 8, 6, 4 to 6, 4 to 5. So all these are very, very important topics. Now, if you add this here, 10 questions from numbers, 25 from geometry, mensuration, 35, and profit loss, about 16 questions, 51. Another 11 questions from trigonometry, 62 plus another 68. Almost 60% to 70% of the questions are predominantly from the topics like percentages, profit loss, numbers, geometry, mensuration, indices, search, trigonometry, algebra. These 7 topics, if you are thorough, 70 marks, kaivi nahi. You'll get 70 marks out of 10. Then coordinate geometry on and off. About 2014, there was 1 question, then not asked. In last 3 years, again, there were 2 questions last year. Data interpretation. Very simple DA. It's like you can't afford to lose any mark here. Very simple data interpretation when compared to your bank exams. Very simple. very simple, straightforward. Maybe little, maybe one hour question may be little lengthier in terms of number of steps or calculation. But I'm saying DA is comparatively very, very easy and compared to your bank exams. And so data interpretation also 5, 5, 5. You can expect some 7 questions. That means if you add all these topics, the important topics like percentage is profit loss. If you take consider time and work, time and distance, numbers, geometry, administration, indices, trigonometry, algebra, DA, almost about 80 questions. 80 out of 100. So 80% of the questions from these topics. Right. Let us look at the summary. You make a note of these points. Very important topics are percentages, profit loss, partnership, geometry, administration, numbers, algebra, trigonometry, and data. These are very important topics. I can classify important topics as ERPB, equation, ratio, proportion, negation, simple and compound interest, time and work, time and distance, averages, which is allegation, as important topics. But as we always tell you, it's a competitive exam. Do not neglect any topic. Avoid selective preparation. All topics are equally important. Do not neglect any of these topics. But while you're preparing for your exam, these are the topics which you need to focus. This is the order. Almost 70-80% of the questions, 60-70% of the questions will be from your important topics itself. You have to practice a lot those topics that are mentioned there. So I'll give you 1 minute of time. Just make a note, or you want to take a screenshot, you can do that. Right, so I don't have any questions now. So let us proceed further. Just make a note, students. These are very important topics. Maybe tier one also, if you can see, these topics are important. There are only 25 questions, but you may not have 12, 13 questions from each of these topics, but you can expect 1 to 1, 2 questions from each of these topics. Yes, students. Right. Done. Let us look at strategies and tips. Okay. What strategy you should follow? You can see here there are total 100 questions. 100 questions. And time is 120 minutes. I'll give you 2 strategies here. Strategy and strategy. Before that, any strategy you would like to suggest, students? Yes, I'll see if you have anything in mind, you can tell me. This video will be available to us on YouTube. Geeta, yes, maybe tomorrow, day after tomorrow, I'll do that. Akhilesh Kumar. Hi, Akhil. Done. Thanks. Okay, any strategy you have in mind, students? Before I discuss this strategy A and strategy B, there are 2 strategies. You have anything in mind? Anything would you like to share? Hello. No replies. USD saying no, sir. We should be perfect in scoring topic rather than completing the whole syllabus. Mahima, sahi hai, but point is like, first you have to focus on these topics, right? Agreed. Very important topics, and don't leave remaining topics. We don't know, right? See, suddenly kuch bhi ho sakta hai. 4 saal mein, 10 saal mein kabhi kabhi tsunami hota hai. Waisa ho sakta hai. So suddenly, apart from this topic, other topics, you about 1 mark, 2 mark, it's a simple interest computer, 4 mark, usme se 10 question. Averages, mixes, allegation, generally we'll get 2 to 4 questions. Suddenly, about 10 to 12 questions. Can happen. I'm not saying it will happen. It can happen. So important topics, yes, very important topics first, then followed by other topics also. Complete the syllabus, but focus on very important topics. Solving questions in 4 phases, like easy to moderate, Dinesh Vanyar, very good. We can do that. Very good. Nice idea. So what Dinesh is trying to tell you is we can solve questions in four pages. What is the four pages? It's not clearly mentioned, but easy to motivate. You want to come back and forth four times, but I think instead of four times, I think you can come and do in two times. Those strategies we'll discuss. Good, Dinesh. As far as I know, there is nothing Yogi is saying. Maintenance speed and accuracy both. Very good, Geeta. Speed and accuracy. Speed, accuracy both you will get only once you practice. You have to write everyday mock test, then only you can improve your speed as well as your accuracy. Right, so let us go and discuss. Let us start discussing these strategies, students. Good, all of you participated. Divide 120 minutes into 10 chunks of time, 10 parts of 12 minutes each. So what I'm trying to tell you is these 120 minutes, you'll have question here if you look at your online screen, students. If you look at your online screen here, your question here and your question palette number 1, 2 is a question palette. And your timing will be given, right? Now I'm saying total 120 minutes, you divide into 10 parts. If I divide by 10, so I'll get 12 minutes of each part. Now, divide 100 questions into 10 minutes. If you divide 100 questions into 10 minutes, what will happen if you divide 100 questions into 10 minutes, 10 parts? 100 by 10, you'll have 10 questions, right? And 120 minutes, you're dividing into 10 parts of 12 minutes. So ideally, I can say 10 questions, set of 10 questions, I need to spend 12 minutes. 10 questions, I need to spend 12 minutes of time. So the whole idea is to identify easy questions in each group and solve them first. It is not trying to answer all questions. So if I am dividing total time into 10 parts, 12 minutes, I am waiting per part. So total questions are, I am dividing into different groups. 10 groups, if I divide 10 questions, I am spending 12 minutes of time. In these 10 questions, I am saying identify easy questions. Identify easy questions, solve them first. What do you mean by easy question? I'll discuss that little bit. Easy question means the question which can be solved using a formula or a shortcut or through back substitution, or if you look at the question, calculations are simple. Identify those questions in a set of 10. You have to solve them first. Then you try to solve moderate level of difficulty questions. And if there are difficult questions, yes, leave them. Don't try to attempt those questions. So when I'm spending 12 minutes of time, in those 12 minutes, there will be about 10 questions. If you are saying, if you are looking at 10 questions, students, I can say about 5 questions, maybe around easy type, another 3 questions, maybe moderate, 1 to 2 questions, maybe difficult. So our focus is in 12 minutes, try to answer those 8 questions, easy questions, followed by moderate level of difficulty. So this is strategy, right? Dividing the time, dividing the group of questions into 10 parts. So 10 questions, 12 minutes. So you have to look at your clock, 12 minutes khatam. Next 10 questions. See, even though you're solving your 8th question, leave that, go back, go to your next set. 24 minutes, third set. 36 minutes, next set. 40. Every 12 minutes, kya hoga na? If I do this way, I'm looking at my time, I'm keeping a tab on my time, and within that time, I'm trying to cover all 100 questions. Otherwise, if you don't have a tab or control on the time, problem will be you end up solving about 50 questions. That's all. The point is, like in examination, how you try and solve each and every question that come your way. Don't do that. Difficult question, yes, that is not for you. That I always tell students, difficult question is for us, not for you. Oh, mera headache hai. Hum logon ka headache hai. That's not your headache. You don't want any gold medal in mathematics, right? You want to get your job. If you want to get your job, identify easy, moderate, solve. So difficult question, kyun de raha hai? He is giving, that is for us. So I have to see what are the difficult questions. And I need to see where should I include in next in our material. And in the classroom when we are discussing, how should I simplify it so that my student will understand. I am saying you should not bother about those difficult. So don't even try to attempt difficult questions. Easy, then do a moderate. So isme kya hoga? All 100 questions you'll be able to read. If you read all 100 questions, point is, you will not miss out any easy question. Otherwise, if you don't have a control on time, you end up doing somewhere around first 40, first 50, first 60, there may be easy questions in the last 40, right? We never know. Where are the easy questions given? Paper is a combination of easy, moderate, and difficult. Easy questions will be placed throughout the paper, right? So they will be distributed throughout the paper. You can't say that easy questions will be at the beginning or throughout the end or in the middle, right? So easy questions will be distributed throughout the paper. Our idea is not to solve all 100, but out of those 100, we need to read all 100 questions, right? This is strategy A. Right? Any questions from your side in strategy A? Pranit, I told you about five questions will be easy, about 50%. Another three questions will be moderate, and one question or two questions may be difficult. Afreen saying hi, sir. Bolo Afreen. Afreen is saying hi. Tell me. Clear strategy A? Shall I move to strategy B now? Right, students? Books and preparation start. Yes, I'll give. Pritesh, let me discuss the strategy. Then I have books also. I'll tell you what needs to be done. You are three. Yes, right. We'll move. Strategy B, right? Divide not the time but questions into three types. So one of our friends was suggesting like easy to moderate. We need to do in four phases. Someone told me that once. Who gave me that? Right. Dinesh has given this question. Dinesh Vanya. Dinesh. So that is what I am trying to say. Instead of dividing the time, what you need to do is divide questions into three types. What are my three types of questions? Type one. Questions based on direct formula, back substitution, shortcut based questions. Each question, if you observe here, this is important, can be solved in 45 seconds to 1 minute. Need not think too much, you need not spend too much of time. Just look at the question, about 45 seconds, 30 to 45 seconds, or even 1 minute, you should be able to answer that question. You have to answer those questions in a first round, right? Then, in a second round, questions that take more than 1 minute, maybe even 2 minutes to solve. That means this type one is easy questions. Type two is moderate level of difficulty questions. Right? Second round, we'll pick up and solve this moderate level of difficulty questions. So instead of four phases, what I'm trying to say is we'll have two phases. First phase, I'll look at the question, I'll answer easy question, I'll read the question, easy question, I'll answer it. Moderate question, I will come back and do in my second round. What should I do? There's something called mark for review. Your question, when you do this mark for review, your question palette, that particular, if you look at a question palette, question number will have a purple color given, right? So mark for review, leave it. Okay, it will take some time. I'll come back and do in my second round, right? Type three, these are the questions where you are much confident that you don't know the approach, you don't know how to solve, but it's going to take. See, the point is like when you look at a question, one, you don't know how to solve. Second, you know, but you definitely feel that it's not a lengthy question, a more of calculation questions. It will take at least 3 minutes to solve. Those kind of questions, better not to attempt such questions. If time permits, okay, I'll do those questions in my third round. So simple students, what you need to do is, let us say you start solving these questions. First round, then you will see, when you read the question, easy question, I'll solve that. If it's a moderate level of difficulty, moderate level of difficult question, I'll mark for review. Right, it will, the question number will be given purple color. Now, easiest of all, a difficult question, leave it. If time permits, I'll come back and. So total paper instead of four phases, back and forth, I can do it in 1 to 100, come back and do my moderate level of difficulty. So if you're solving, like I told you, right, 10 may say 5 easy ranking. That means about 50%, 40 to 50% easy. So in the first round, I'll try to solve about 40 to 50 questions. I'll come back. There'll be three moderate level. That means another 20, 30 I'll do in the second. 70, 80 questions. Difficult questions, I don't even touch those questions. I'll leave. So instead of time, we can divide questions into three types. Easy, moderate, difficult. If you mark for review, once you come back, let's say 1 to 100 is completed. When you come back, you need not again go in serial order. Just look at your question palette. Whichever questions, question numbers are showing purple in color, that means, okay, those questions I'm going to solve. So whatever questions you have solved, those will be in green color. The questions you are ready to, you are trying to solve in your second round, it will be in purple color. Third, red color. Red color means difficult question. I'm not going to solve that. This is strategy B. Any questions from your side? I can't see last line. It is better not to attempt such question. Difficult type of questions, I'm saying not to attempt. That's all. You have three difficult questions, I'm saying don't attempt. That's all. Difficult question means either you don't know, or second thing will be I know, but lengthy calculation based questions. We'll do it in the second round, right? So what Dinesh has suggested is instead of four phases, Dinesh, it is better you try to put it in two phases. Easy questions, then I'll do my difficult. I'll do my moderate level of difficult questions. Right? Let us look at reference book, students. One, revise from time, mock tests, booklets, handouts given. The two things you can see here. One, we have SSC CGLE Tier 2 test series. SSC CGLE Tier 2 test series. You can purchase this test series, you'll get mock tests. Or you can revise from, if you already a student of SSC, you have given mock tests, you'll be having booklets, you'll be having handouts, you can revise from that. If you are a non-time student, yes, we are providing test series, mock tests, you can purchase those mock tests. Right, students? This is called SSC CGLE Tier 2 mock test series. Then, practice book. There's a practice book by Kiran Publications. On all these topics, you can purchase these practice books. Most importantly, refer previous SSC CGLE exam papers. Refer previous SSC CGLE exam papers. Right? Make a note. Right? Any questions from your side now? When will we conduct Tier 2 All India Mock Test? Pranit, we'll do that. We'll do that once the notification is released. Once we get the dates, we'll release the schedule. By attempting mocks, we can choose either A or B strategy. Yes, Yogi. You see, the point is like you. The point is whatever strategies we have discussed, you have to implement in those mock tests. Once you implement those mock tests, what happens is you implement in one of the mock test strategy, in other mock tests you implement strategy B. Then what happens is you will have that you see which one is suitable to you. Accordingly, you can go ahead and apply that. We practice only Kiran books. See, the point is like you look at our material. If you want any, if you are non-time student preparing on your own, that is why I told you Kiran publication book you can refer. Now only Kiran publications is like, I am not saying only Kiran publications, but among all the books, Kiran publication is a decent book. Second point is like refer previous year paper. That is one thing which you all of you should do before you solve any book. Because if you refer previous year papers, original actual papers, you will get an idea what type of questions we are coming across. Now we'll discuss topic by topic. We'll discuss what kind of questions we are coming across. We'll discuss, right? When will we connect Tier 2? I discuss this. Any books will give free material. What do you mean by Pranit, your query not clear? When will we conduct online classes and mock tests? Okay, online classes, maybe very soon we will do that for SSC Tier 2. We have a plan, but I'm not committing anything online. No. So we'll do that. Maybe in the next 2 weeks, we'll have one more seminar in English language. Maybe in that we'll announce. We'll see. What about solving CAT papers? No, Dinesh Vanya. No, no. CAT papers. CAT is a different ballgame. No, not CAT papers. Not. See, the point is like CAT will be a different testing platform, different question type, they're altogether different idea. But here, when you see here, the point is like SSC will be a much lower level, right? When compared to what you call that. See, the point is like the question types are different. So I'm saying CAT, solving CAT questions will not help. You have to focus on this SSC Tier 2 actual exam papers. So one, you will refer previous exam papers. If you want to have that flavor, you can take out test series. You'll get that. Where can we find previous year questions? Online you will get Akhilesh, or you can purchase Kiran Publications previous year book, right? Online also you can get it. Can you please put the slide from strategy A, Geeta? Okay, I'll put it, you can copy it down. I could not write due to internet issue. Okay, Geeta, I'm just going back. Just give me 2 minutes. Okay, this is strategy A, make a note. Ayush is asking, solving bank questions can help to some extent. Yes, I told you about 60%, 70% is common. But thing is like you observe topics like trigonometry, topics like algebra, topics like coordinate geometry, topics like numbers. You don't have these models more, these chapters you don't learn in depth in your bank exams. Algebra to padhte nahi ho, coordinate geometry, trigonometry hai nahi bank syllabus. numbers high, lekin you will get very, very, very one question once in a blue moon type. So, but these topics are very important. Whatever I told you, trigonometry, algebra, quadratic geometry, numbers, indices, search, you need to study in detail these question types. So in bank exams, for these five topics, you need to prepare separately. Other topics, yes, bank exam preparation, like percentages, profit loss ho gaya, time and work ho gaya, time and distance ho gaya, your ERPV ho gaya, averages ho gaya, mixes, yes. Common 60-70% syllabus. So those topics which you are preparing for bank definitely will help. But if you are preparing for bank exam, there are five topics which you need to focus additionally: numbers, indices, search, coordinate, trigonometry, algebra. It's a alag se padhna chahiye. Okay, Ayush. Geeta, if you are done, then just tell me, I'll change the slide. So total we have paper 1 and paper 2, 30 mock tests. Someone is asking how many mock tests in test series. Total 30, 15 quant and 15 English. See this option, like, sir, I am good at English, I don't want, I want to purchase only quant. Who option diya hua hai, go to timeforeducation.com, SSC page or your bank exam page, you can purchase that. Only quant you can purchase, only English you can purchase, 15-15 or do mila ke 30 questions also you can purchase. Right, Geeta, done. Okay, right. This is tier 2. This is strategy B. Type 1, type 2, type 3. Now you do one thing. You just go. I think most of your Time for Bank Exams app, we also have Time for SSE app. Just download that. Time for Bank Exams app. All of you, most of you are using this. There's one more app called Time for SSE. Right? Download this app. Here also we are giving daily tests. And we are giving you what you called free mock test. Necessary path to write. Daily 10 questions you will get here. And those who are free students, you can, that means those are non-time students. Time students anyways are giving GK classes. Non-time students, we are providing you GK classes Monday to Friday. Open. It's you can actually register for free. So out of these 5 days, 3 days we are giving bank GK. And 2 days we are giving you, providing you with SSC GK, right? So non-time students also, you can refer for, you can register for free content. You can watch this GK classes for non-time students, right? These are reference books. Please scroll, what to type in type 3? Nothing, type 3 is like difficult questions. You need to leave type 3. Okay, I'll do something like this. Let's see. One second. Now, can you see here? There are questions where you either don't know the approach or you know, but it will take at least 3 minutes to solve. Those are difficult questions. I'm saying better not to attempt such questions. Better not to attempt such questions. That is your slide. Right. Is it available in App Store? Yogi, you're asking Play Store? Are you asking about Apple? No, it is not there in iOS operating. Is there only an what you called Android operating system? This is a particular app. For the expected cutoffs of the tier 1 and tier 2, we'll see. Momita, sir, in SSC CGLE for CBI course tier 2, we'll conduct how many marks? What is this question? Dilip, I couldn't get, I'm not able to follow this, I don't understand this question. Can you repeat this? Bank student can log into SSC port. We need to take admission for that. You can log in, but if you want to have access to those tests, you should have a you should join for SSC CGLE. Then only you'll get access for it. Repeat that GK classes, Shivani Kataria. Okay, we are doing Monday to Friday 5 GK sessions. So those are for time student as well as for non-time student. You have to go to website timeforeducation.com. In bank exams, you are given a link. Register for free GK classes. You have to register there. Then 5 classes, 3 will be on banking and economy, and 2 will be for SSE. maybe physics or chemistry or biology or history. Okay, you see, no issues. Okay. So what is here? What does the exam demand? Just see it. One speed. What is the second one? Accuracy. One is speed, other is accuracy. Right. Let us look at preparation plan. DRDO exam pattern is also like SSC exam. So yes, to you, this coaching, this preparation will also help. So it is similar to that, but not. I can't say exactly, but similar. Revise the basic concepts, formulas, shortcut, alternate. See, the point is like what you should do as a part of your preparation. Once, see, the point is when you are appearing for tier 2, that means you have already prepared for tier 1. When you are preparing for tier 1, tier 2, almost question types will be, tier 2 will be slightly there, very, very, very marginal difference will be there. So you are automatically preparing for tier 2. So before your tier 2 exam, you have to again revise the concepts, formulas, shortcuts, alternate approaches, whatever you have prepared for your tier 1 exam. Revise all those once again. Then improve your conceptual knowledge. Tier 2 concepts, basic concepts, you have to be thorough with. This is one important. Write one mock test daily. This will improve your speed, time management. This will also help you to devise your strategy. When I am saying daily one mock test, khali kwan nahi, you write one mock test on paper 1, another mock test on paper 2. So one quant mock test, one English mock test. So daily one mock test, one on paper 1, another on paper 2. And what is important point is just observe students, analysis of the mock test. This is very, very important. See, writing mock test is not a big deal. Anybody can do that, right? But after writing the mock test, you have to, what you call, analyze the mock test, right? So, SI tier 2 is paper 1, paper 2, na Dilip. SI in CBI is like paper 1, paper 2 common, right? So paper 1 in tier 2, paper 1 is 200 marks, paper 2 is 200 marks. After this, you will have descriptive in tier 3. Tier 2, you have only paper 1, paper 2. How can I write, sir, any app? I said, no, you just type it in that question box only, I'll get it. I'm not saying write. Type it in question marks, I'll get it. So friends, what is important is analysis of the mock test. What I need to do is, let us say you have taken this 100 questions, right? In the examination, 100 questions, 120 minutes, that is 2 hours. You have solved the paper. You attempted about, let's say, 60 to 70 questions you attempted. How many you have left out? Another 30, 40 you have not attempted. What I'm trying to tell you is, while doing the analysis of the paper, first, you need to spend another two hours, try to solve these 30 to 40 questions again. Why I'm asking you to spend another 2 hours? Because these 30 to 40 questions I have not attempted in the exam. There may be two reasons. One, either I don't know, or I don't know the approach to solve those questions, or second, or these are difficult questions. There are two reasons, right? There can be two reasons. One, either I don't know the approach how to solve, or secondly, this may be difficult question. So I am saying, spend another 2 hours, try to attempt these 30 to 40 questions. Taken by surprise, out of these 40, you can solve another 20 to 25 questions easily. Sir, why are you not able to do during the examination time? Because there are two, again, there may be some reasons. Like one, time management. Second, you will be nervous in the examination. That is the two reasons why you are not attempted. Another, after the exam, you are sitting and solving another 1 hour, 2 hours, definitely you can solve another 20 questions. Still, after that time, there are about 15 questions left which you are not able to solve. These 15 questions may be difficult questions or moderate to difficult questions. You try to take the look at the solution given, or you take the help of the faculty member in the doubt session. You get these questions cleared. Analysis is very, very important. Then, coming to the 60 to 70 questions, there are 60 to 70 questions you attempted. I'm saying accuracy. Accuracy should be, I'm saying 90%. But minus 10 question attempt, 9 correct, 1 wrong, accepted. 1 correct, 9 wrong, not accepted. Not at all accepted. Right? So accuracy is very, very, your strike rate should be 90%. 100%, DK. 100 should at least 90%. I'm saying out of the 60 to 70 questions, there may be about 5 to 7 questions or 5 to 10 questions which you have made a mistake, which are wrong, you have marked a wrong answer. I am saying just identify the reason why you have marked a wrong answer for these 10 questions. This is very important, because the point is, like, those 10 questions you are marking, you are answering in the exam, you mark your answer, means you are very confident that you know the question, you know the approach, and you know the answer. Whatever you have got the answer, that is correct. Still, you have made a mistake. That means I am saying identify this mistake, pinpoint it. What is the mistake? Is it a mistake in reading the question, understanding the question, or is the mistake in what is called, is it a conceptual mistake, or is it a silly calculation mistake? Kya hoga na? If I identify this mistake, it will be there forever in your brain recorded. When similar type of question appear next time, are last time this question, it will strike you, I made a mistake in calculation. Are last time isko main galat padha tha, are last time isko galat samjha. You will get that, immediately you will get that idea, then you will take precaution, you will not make that mistake, you will not repeat that mistake when you are writing your next marks. So 60 to 70 you attempted, another 30-40 you have not attempted, try that, another 120, 2 hours, 1.5 hours you spend, write that. You have solved about 20-25. Good. The questions which are not able to solve, take the help of the solution or doubt session faculty member. You meet the faculty member in the doubt session, get that clear. Then, out of those 70 which you attempted, 5 to 10 are wrong. I am saying those wrong questions, identify what's the reason for the mistake. This is the analysis part. Then, once you observe this, these questions you are not able to solve, these 30 to 40 questions, these 30 to 40 questions may fall into a couple of subtopics. So generally what happens is, here then student will come back and say, sir, mujhse time and distance nahi ho payega, sir, I'll not be good for time and distance. So I'll tell them, go, please take out all your mock tests. Kitne time to make 15 mock tests. That each mock test you'll take an average about 5 questions, you get 75 questions on time and distance. Solve all these questions, your SM booklet, study material booklet, jo aapne prepare kiya, uske test, sectional test. Then you take the 75 questions from mock tests and your previous year papers. At least last 3-4 years papers. You try to take this in order, you try to solve this question. What happens is, if I do this way, two things will happen. One, my conceptual knowledge will increase, will improve. Second, my confidence level will improve. Third, jo bhi, let us say, booklets plus sectional test plus mock test previous year papers, you have solved somewhere around 200 to 250 questions. Isme se, let us say, out of this, you may not be able to solve about some 30-40 questions. Believe me, friend, these 30-40 questions will be either one or two subtopics. That means, taken by surprise, those 40 questions may be from linear races and average speed, or may belong to average speed and relative speed, may belong to boats and streams, may belong to trains. That means you don't have problem with the entire topic, you have problem with those two particular subtopics. That means if these questions are from trains and boats and streams, that means your concept, you are making some mistakes in your concept is not clear in times and boats and streams. So again, you have to revise those concepts. Similarly, you take your any topic, you can do like this. You just look at your study material booklet, sectional test, mock test, previous year paper. So I'm saying analysis of the mock test is very important. So once you have written this test, about 30 questions or 25 questions or 40 questions which you're not able to attempt, classify them. Which questions I'm not able to solve in the exam? They belong to about 3-4 chapters. Within that 3-4 chapters also, they belong to some subtopic, maybe one or two subtopics. Agar aap geometry le liye, sir, I am not able to solve questions related to equilateral triangles. I am making a mistake, questions related to geometric centers, like in center, circumcenter, center. That means your concept is not clear there. That will give you an idea, okay, these are my weak areas, friends. I need to improve on my weak areas. Yes, these are my subtopics which are not clear. Again, look at your video, again, revise your concepts. The point is, like, strong area will be always your strong area, but important point is, if you want to improve your score, you have to improve your weak area. If you improvise your weak areas, that means work out more number of questions under a particular topic, get that concept clear. I'm saying your weak area will also become your strong area by the time you write your exam. Automatically, overall, this will improve your score. That is what I'm trying to say, right? So analysis of mock test, identify your strong areas and weak areas, improvise your weak area. That means, does those concepts, more number of questions you need to solve on those particular topics. previous year original paper. This is one thing everyone should do. Last 3 to 4 year papers you need to see. This will improve your familiarity with the commonly asked question types. Because any exam you take RRB, like IBPS, PO, IBPS, any exam, just have a glance. Look at last 3 to 4 year paper. That will give you a broad idea about what question types are asked in an examination. What kind of question types, right? Can I refer school books? Sivaprasad is asking for basic concept. You can. 8th standard, 9th standard, 10th standard. You can refer. Siva, you can do that. So, as I always tell you, these are things which should be in here handy and you should be ready with these. Multiplication tables, squares, cubes, reciprocal values, complements and percentage calculations. These are the things, basic things to improve your speed in your quant. You have to be ready with your multiplication tables, 20 tables. In your quant preparation also, we have discussed in detail 20 into 20. Squares of at least first 50 natural numbers, cubes of first 20 natural numbers. Reciprocal value, there is 1 by 2, 1 by 3, up to 1 by 12, including their multiples. That means 2 by 12, 3 by 12, so on. Complements of 100 and percentage calculations. So this is what percent of that is what percentage of this. So this percentage calculation will actually improve your speed, right? These are the things, basic things which you should learn. Now, what I am going to do in the next 15-20 minutes is, as I have, Swati is asking some question, as I have time, study material, so do I need to purchase Kiran Publications books? See, the point is, like, you don't purchase Kiran Publications books. You can refer previous year Kiran Publications. Don't purchase any book. If you have time material, that is more than sufficient. See, we have a big R&D team. Their job is to look at all previous year questions, whatever exams are conducted, try to include. Our material is updated, up to date, right? All models are included in your material. If you have material, just practice that. But previous year papers, yes, Kiran Publication books, you can purchase for it. Now, what I'm trying to do in next 15-20 minutes, this is something which you need to focus for it. Now, the topics which I told you about 60%, 70% of the question. What are those topics? Percentages, profit loss. What you call simple test, computer, geometry, mensuration, numbers, and trigonometry, algebra. These topics I have listed down. If you observe last 2 to 3 years, I have listed down certain, see what maximum number of questions appeared from which subtopics. Those topics, those concepts I have listed down. So friends, just you take a photo from yourself, because if I give you time to note down, it will be very, very, what you call, the session will go behind the 2 hours. So I'm saying, just listen. And we'll upload this in YouTube. You can just pause it and watch it as many times as possible. Or if you want, you can take a photo with your mobile phone. Not an issue. So each, I'm not discussing all the topics. Very important topics. Most of the questions are based on what subtopics, what concepts. Those are the things we are going to discuss. Right. Let us start with percentages, profit and loss. Now, before I start, now you have any queries, any questions, students? If you have any questions, you can tell me. You can ask. Any questions or should I move forward? This is important. This is the whole crux, the whole story lies here. We have analyzed last few years' papers. So Simran is saying, no, sir. Okay, theek hai. Aage badhte hai Simran. Percentages, profit and loss, dekhiye. Market price, discount, partnership, profit loss, percentage, all put together, you'll have 16 to 20 questions. Questions, if you observe last 3-4 years, are based on application of percentages. Okay. Are based on application of, what do you mean by application of percentages? Solve percentage related questions, finding maximum marks, SRA. Preeti is asking, first ka jo slide se fir se dikha sakte hai kya? Which slide numbers, Preeti? Topic wise breakup wale? Preeta, sorry. Preeta. Topic wise breakup wale ekdam initial wale theek hai. She's asking, I think she has some query. Students, give it 2 minutes. Let us go back to our first slide and come back. Yes, sir. Ye wale Preeta. यही वाला है प्रीतम। हाँ ठीक है आप फोटो ले लीजिए, वो ब्रेकअप मैंने दिया है लास्ट 4-5 साल में, टेक दैट फोटो। आपके मोबाइल में फोटो ले लीजिए या यूट्यूब पे फिर से मैं लगा दूंगा, नो इश्यूज राइट। हो गया तो बोलो, मैं आगे स्लाइड बढ़ूंगा, जस्ट फोटो खींच लीजिए बाद में देख लीजिए। हो गया राइट, नेक्स्ट वन। प्रीता आपने बोला, आप ओके बोले तो मैं आगे बढ़ूंगा, यस राइट। सॉरी सॉरी, हाँ देख लीजिए। राइट हाँ, यूएसरी नेगेटिव मार्किंग इज देयर 1/4, तो ईच क्वेश्चन 2 मार्क्स ना, 1/4 मींस 0.5 मार्किंग नेगेटिव मार्किंग इन क्वाड पेपर, इंग्लिश 200 क्वेश्चंस 200 मार्क्स, सो ईच क्वेश्चन 1 मार्क, सो 1/4 ऑफ 1 इज 0.25। आगे बढ़ो प्रीता, शेयर नेम ऑफ योर YouTube चैनल। ओके वन सेकंड, लेट मी जस्ट गो टू YouTube, ये स्ट्रेटजी बी है, इसका भी फोटो ले लो। आई विल टेल यू स्वाति, आगे बढ़ूं। यस सर, ओके चलो आगे बढ़ते हैं। ठीक है राइट राइट, आ गया राइट। परसेंटेजेस प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस राइट, जस्ट हियर अबाउट 16-20 क्वेश्चंस एप्लीकेशंस, इट्स ओके प्रीता राइट, एप्लीकेशंस आर परसेंटेजेस, देन योर क्वेश्चंस अमंग रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन कॉस्ट प्राइस, सेलिंग प्राइस, डिस्काउंट एंड मार्केट प्राइस राइट। सो सेलिंग प्राइस एंड कॉस्ट प्राइस यू हैव अ रिलेशन, एसपी इज इक्वल टू, अच्छा मैं एक बताऊंगा, 100 प्लस आर माइनस प्रॉफिट और लॉस परसेंटेज बाय 100, रिलेशन बिटवीन एसपी एंड सीपी राइट। अगर प्रॉफिट है तो प्लस लेना है, लॉस है तो माइनस लेना है। सो एसपी सीपी रिलेशन, डिस्काउंट मार्केट प्राइस रिलेशन, एसपी एंड मार्केट प्राइस रिलेशन, ये सारे क्वेश्चंस यू विल गेट इन योर एग्जाम बेस्ड ऑन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट राइट। देन क्वेश्चन टाइप्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक आर यूजुअली रिपीटेड, सेम क्वेश्चंस आर रिपीटेड ओवर ए पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड दीज आर वेरी डूएबल, दीज आर वेरी डूएबल क्वेश्चंस राइट। सिंपल इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट्स 4 क्वेश्चन, दीज क्वेश्चन आर बेस्ड ऑन सिंपल इंटरेस्ट में फॉर्मुला बेस्ड, एंड फॉर्मुला बेस्ड क्वेश्चन ऑन कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट, कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एस आई एंड सी आई, सिंपल इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट्स कॉम्बिनेशन, एंड यू हैव इंस्टॉलमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, दिस वन थिंग व्हिच यू नीड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल, दिस वर फर्स्ट टाइम आस्क्ड इन द ईयर 2018, उससे पहले वाले साल में नहीं था, 17, 16, 15, यू डोंट हैव एनी इंस्टॉलमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, बट लास्ट ईयर देयर वर इंस्टॉलमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, बोथ आर सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इंस्टॉलमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस, कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट इंस्टॉलमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चन, देयर वाज अबाउट आई थिंक एक क्वेश्चन कुछ था 2018 में और एक क्वेश्चन या दो क्वेश्चन थे, सो आई एम सेइंग दीस आर इंस्टॉलमेंट बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस। हाउ कैन वी कम्युनिकेट टू भरत सर फ्रॉम हैदराबाद टेकिंग बैंक करंटली व्हाट अबाउट डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग द सेशन, आपके डाउट्स यू जस्ट पोस्ट योर डाउट्स इन योर व्हाट यू कॉल टू थिंग्स यू कैन डू, यू जस्ट पोस्ट योर डाउट्स इन योर व्हेन द सेशन इज गोइंग एंड दोस डाउट्स विल बी गिवन टू अस, दोस विल बी आंसर्ड, or you can send us a mail right, I give the email id info@timeforeducation.com, whatever questions you have you just send them, we'll get them answered right, timeforeducation.com. YouTube channel is, you just go to YouTube, you just type time for education, you'll get the channel, just subscribe to that. Geeta clear, you send a mail to info, whatever questions you have, we'll get them answered. Geeta right. simple interest, compound interest, combination based questions. Combination based questions means like difference between 2 years, difference between 3 years, or SICA combo. These questions will be asked more. No, geometry. This thing you just take a photograph. Questions are based on basic properties of geometric figures. Like maybe you take your parallel lines concept, or you take your triangle concept. Basic figures you'll have questions, and questions on equilateral triangles. If you observe last 3-4 years, most of the questions from equilateral triangles. Okay, Geeta. Basic proportionality theorem, geometric points. So most of the questions on centroid. Then you also have questions on median, in center, circumcenter. Just here, relation between circumradius and in radius. This is capital R, this is smaller. In an equilateral triangle, based on the equilateral triangle, there is a relation between circumradius and in radius. Based on this also, you have questions. Just you these are most of the questions in last few years are asked on these particular topics, right? Basic figures, geometric figures, equilateral triangles, basic proportionality theorem, centroid, in center, median, circumcenter, or relation between in center, circumradius, and in radius in an equilateral triangle. Then some of internal and external organs are, angles in a polygon, right? You take a polygon, total sum of all exterior angles, interior angles, each interior angle is how much, exterior angle is how much, based on that. Then angles in a semicircle, alternate segment theorem, direct and transverse common tangents. Now if you see here, there are different types of circles, right? Two circles which are separate, two circles which are touching each other, two intersecting circles. So you have direct common tangents, transverse common tangents. So how many direct common tangents, how many transverse common tangents, length of direct common tangent, length of transverse common tangent, all these questions will be asked here. All those students are preparing in Gmail, can you send PPT in Gmail? Praneet, I think I'm afraid I can't do that. I'm sorry. We'll upload in YouTube, no? Don't worry. Maybe we'll do for all the students. No, it's not possible. I think I can't do that. You just take a photo, Praneet. Anyways, I'll upload this in YouTube. You can watch it anytime. So just these are the points in geometry. Now, mensuration. About 12 to 15 questions we have discussed. Direct formula application questions, right? If you remember the formula, you'll get the answer. If you don't remember, you'll not get the answer. So whatever mensuration question, I'm saying that mensuration questions will be easy to solve compared to your geometry questions. Because you have to just remember the formula. Equilateral triangle. What's the area? What's the perimeter? Trapezium. Then these are most of the questions are appeared from these particular figures. Then your questions on circle. If you look at your what you call three-dimensional figures, your cone, cube, cuboid, cylinder, sphere, frustum, pyramid. Frustum of pyramid, right? So these questions, these things you have to be ready with: lateral surface area, total surface area, volume. Those formulas should be in handy, right? Sir, please tell your YouTube channel name. Just go to YouTube, just type time for education. Just subscribe to that, time for education. Right, so these are three-dimensional figures. So you have three-dimensional figures, you have prism as well as pyramid. What is a prism? That bottom and top shape are same. For example, you take a cuboid, you have a rectangle, you join this, right? Triangular prism is a cuboid. Bottom and top face is same. If you take a cube, cube is square face. Now, your bottom and top faces are same. What is a pyramid? Cone is a pyramid, right? You don't have any, see, all the figure will be like this. If you look at from the top, you have only one point here. This is a cone at the top. Again, cylinder is a prism. Top circle. So you have to learn lateral surface area, total surface area, volume of two-dimensional figures as well as three-dimensional figures. Focus on application-based questions also. Based on this particular formula, if you have any application-based questions, you can definitely have to look at those application-based questions also. Algebra. About 4 to 8 questions. Algebra is one thing which you generally have not come across after your school days, right? School level, we might have done polynomials, right? Factorization of polynomials, all those, right? Just you have to refresh those things. Questions are based on algebraic identities. What do you mean algebraic identities? Ratta varne by heart. A plus B whole square. A square plus B square plus 2AB. A minus B whole square. A plus B whole cube. A minus B whole cube. A cube plus B cube. All these algebraic identities. Kuch nahi karna hai. Usko samajhna nahi hai. have to by heart. Just mensuration you're by heart, just by heart the algebraic identities. Most of the questions are given in algebraic, from algebraic identities. Then factorization of your polynomials, simplification of your polynomials, and simplification of fractions. Right? These are the question types which you generally come across. Right? So first important thing is by heart this algebraic identity. Then factorization, simplification of polynomials, and simplification of fractions. Time and work, time and distance, you observe these students, you have about 10 questions from time and work and time and distance. But if you observe here, most of the questions are efficiency based in time and work and pipes and systems. Pipes and systems questions are similar to your time and work questions. Only difference is pipes and systems questions, you are filling pipe, it is doing a positive work, you will add them. Emptying pipe, it is doing a negative work, you will subtract. Efficiency based questions. What do you mean by efficiency based questions? If you observe in bank exams, also come across these questions, right? A is two times as efficient as B. A is two times as efficient as B. Or we'll say two times as fast as B. A is working at half the efficiency of B. Or A is working at 20% more efficiency, 30% more. All these are efficiency based questions, right? So you will have more of efficiency based questions, most of the questions in time and work and from pipes and systems. Then if you observe time and distance, if you observe last 2-3 years, definitely you have questions on average speed, boats and streams, trains in almost every exam. Apart from your general questions, I can say these are repetitively asked questions. Average speeds, boats and streams and trains. Just focus on this trigonometry. 8 to 10 questions. Trigonometric identities. What do you mean by trigonometric identities? Is Hindu Jadi has left. I request you to share this presentation to our mail. It will be helpful for us. Thank you, sir. I'll try. See, as a policy, we can't do this. I'm sorry. Okay. Trigonometric identities. Kya hoga trigonometric identities? Sin square plus cos square is equal to 1. Secant square, cosecant square, tan square, cot square. So all these relationships you have to be ready with. One second. And then you have to be ready with multiple angles, sub-multiple angles. What do you mean multiple sub? Sine 2 theta, sine 3 theta, a value. These are formulas you have to remember. And if you observe in trigonometry, out of those 8 questions or 10 questions or 11 questions, heights and distances, you can expect 2 questions. Sometimes you also have 3 questions from heights and distances. So heights and distances is an easy topic. Just you have to focus on what you call angle of elevation, angle of depression, right? So very easy. But basic thing is that you have to understand trigonometric identities. You have to remember multiple sub-multiple angles. So aapko by heart karna hai, and those should be handy. Difficulty of this, maybe algebra you take, trigonometry you take, easy to moderate. But friends, 10th class level hai. Not more than that. Trigonometry, don't take your intermediate paper, one paper, two, then try to solve all inverse trigonometric functions. Not asked in the exam. 10th class trigonometry, up to 10th class algebra, up to 10th class coordinate geometry. Oh, that is more than sufficient. So friends, 10th class trigonometry, if you can open the book and if you read all the multiples, submultiples and trigonometric identities, that will take care of your trigonometry preparation. Numbers 8 to 12 questions, important topic, not important for your bank exams, but very important for your SSE exams. Definitely, your questions on LCM and HCF, finding LCM, finding HCF, relation between LCM and HCF, right? Product of two numbers is equal to, direct question was there, a standard relation. Product of two numbers is equal to LCM into HCF. If you know this formula, you'll get one mark in your examination. So LCM model 1, LCM model 2, HCF model 1, HCF model 2, remainder same, divisor same, all models you have to be ready. Bodmas rule, not asked, maybe 2014, 15, 16, 17, we don't have question, but last year, we had about 1 to 2 questions based on Bodmas rule. So Bodmas, all of you know, right? Brackets of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. Then divisibility rules, divisibility rule for 2, divisibility rule for 3, divisibility rule for 7, standard divisibility rules, of course, you should actually should know that. Application of remainder theorem, right? There will be questions on remainder theorem also. Recurring decimals and simplifications. So 1 by 3 is equal to 0.3333 bar. So what will happen is 0.3 bar convert into fraction, 0.25 bar convert into fraction, or simplification questions, which are based on this what you call board mass rule. These questions are asked in your examination. Most of these questions from these particular topics. So recurring decimal, simplification, board mass. Last year there were questions. Update on YouTube. We'll do that. We'll do this. Right, indices search about 3 to 6 questions. The questions are based on rules of indices. We have certain rules of indices, right? A power 0 is equal to 1, A power 1 is equal to A, then A power M into A power N is equal to A power M plus N. Those like that, we have about 12-13. You have to be ready with bases are equal, powers are equal, powers are equal, bases are equal. You will have, if you learn those indices rule, then you will have questions like simplification questions from indices search, solving or finding out X value. Then if you take search, rationalization, conjugate search, rationalization, these questions will be asked, and finding the square root of a positive, finding the positive square root of a third, a plus 2 would be from, you have to find out the square root of a third, rationalization, all these things you should be ready with. Right, this is about important topics. Now DI, if you see, we have only 4 models in a SSC. You have table, you have pie chart, you have bar graph, you have line, right? Now, all of you also preparing for bank exam, these are very easy. There's certain things which you should keep in mind while solving a DI set. Spend some time in reading the data and the questions. So first read the data. You'll try, if you read the data, you'll come to know what kind of questions are being asked in your examination. That means what that if you read the data, what will happen is you will come to know the questions or the data is based on sales or manufacturing or production. Then read the questions. Then I'll come to know what kind of questions is asked. Then note down the units. Maybe rupees are given in lakhs, crores. So note down the units. Can you go back to the data interpretation slide? One second. I forgot to take the screenshot. 1 minute, Momita. I'm going back. Table, pie chart, bar graph, line graph. Table, pie chart, bar graph, line graph. Another 5-10 minutes, we'll wind up. If you have any questions in between, you just be ready with the questions. If you have anything, you can be done. Okay, right. So spend some time in reading the title and the questions. Then make a note of the units. If additional information is given, you must and should read that information. What do you mean by additional information? Apart from the data given in the table or a pie chart, outside a note will be given. Or a footnote, a star mark will be given, some information is given. This is known as additional information. Additional information is given, you must also read that information. Based on that information, there might be 1 or 2 questions. Sometimes what happens is, if I miss that information, all 5 questions might go wrong. Then observe, this is important. All questions in a set are not of same difficult level. This is what I'm trying to tell you. True for quant questions, always for true for your DI. Out of 5 questions, there will be 2 to 3 easy questions or 1 to 2 moderate questions, 1 difficult questions. Difficult means lengthy calculation based questions. Don't solve them. You just focus on your easy questions and moderate level of difficulty. Right, students? Now, just I've given few points for your tables, pie charts, etc. Just see tables. These are easy to understand. Generally, table will be given in rows and columns. Tables will be given in rows and columns. Don't find out unnecessarily row total or column total. Depending on the question, we can do that. That's what I've written here. Don't find out sum of all rows and columns. Just don't write all the data again in a rough sheet. Read the question, whatever data is required, write on your rough sheet, you can solve. Bar graphs and line graphs. Bar graphs, you have normal bar graph, you have a stacked bar graph, and you have a histogram. Right? So what is histogram? Given something like this is histogram. This is histogram, your frequency distribution. What is stacked bar graph? Stacked bar graph is one above the other. These are all models, right? This is A, let's say this is B, let's say this is C, A, B, C, one above the other. This is stacked bar. A few questions can be answered in line graph and bar graph, can be answered using observation. That means by looking at the difference in the bar graph or slope of the line graph, certain questions can be answered orally without using pen and paper. Then the next model is pie charts. Pie chart, what happens is the data in pie chart can be represented in percentage. If it is represented in percentage, total is equal to 100%. Data can be represented in degrees. If it is represented in degrees, total is equal to 360 degrees. Right? So when, let us say, generally SSC exams, you don't have 2 pie charts. Generally, what happens, sometimes if you come across 2 pie charts, What happens is you just compare the base value, total given here, total given here. Just compare the base values. Once if you compare the base values, certain questions will become easy to solve. If two pie chart questions are given, generally you'll get only one pie chart questions in your SSC exam. So let us look at question types. See, the representation of data will be different. Table, pie chart, line graph, bar graph, but more or less question types will remain same. Most of the questions are based on your percentage related questions or your average related questions or ratio concept questions. And these are the three topics which are generally tested in your DA. Question may be based on percentage concepts. Increase percentage, decrease percentage, more percentage, less. This is what percentage of that, that is what percentage of this, this is what percentage of total. Or average, what's the average in this given 4 years? Ratio. These are the concepts generally tested. Data may be in several forms, but more or less question types will remain same. So I'm saying addition based questions are percentage based questions. Percentage based questions, you will be asked overall growth rate or average growth rate. There can be observation based questions. Then if you have any questions, you can ask me. I'll come to the end of the session. Any questions from your side, students? So you can refer SSC tier 2. SSC tier 2 test series you can take. Your total 30 mock tests, quant 15, reasoning 15, total 30 mock tests. You can take quant separately, reasoning separately, or you can take combination. About 60, Dinesh. About 60. Right. No, point is 60 to 70 should be comfortably should be able to solve. One more point is YouTube channel. Those who have missed out, just go to YouTube, just type Time for Education. Time for Education channel. Subscribe to that. We'll upload this video also there. One more point is like we'll be doing a similar session for English preparation in 2 weeks down the line. English preparation. You were doing this maybe 2 weeks down, right? So shall we wind up here? Sir, please do a webinar for SSC preparation. Abhi to kiya na. Acha, tier one, Ayush. I'm time students. How can I access those test series? Time student, Anjali is like your time student SSC. Agar tum time student ho. You just send your mail, your details to info@timeforeducation.com. I'll reply. Anjali, just my phone puts my question. Ayush, who asked this question? Anjali only. info@timeforeducation.com. Just we'll answer that question. Because it all depends on when did you join with all those variants also. So let me answer through your mail only. Just send your mail to info@timeforeducation.com. Ayush, you mean webinar for SSC tier 1 you're talking about, right? We'll do that. Upload on YouTube also. Yes, tier 1. Karenge, Ayush. Jarur karenge. Pradeep, yes, we'll do that. Pradeep, we'll do that. Theek hai, Anjali. info@timeforeducation.com. Okay, theek hai. Mail chalo kar dijiye. Dusre to hum log discuss karenge, right? Any questions, student, from your side? Theek hai. Thank you so much for taking out time and attending the session. Hope this is helpful. Time booklet is more than enough, Pritesh. More than enough. SSC ka booklet is more than enough. GK ke class kaise attend kar sakte hai? Megha Sharma. Just go to our website. Usme aapko register for free GK content bolke rahega. Just you have to register yourself. You can attend. If you have any problem, you can send a mail to info@timeforeducation.com. We'll give you the what you call the link. Just go through timeforeducation.com. Go to bank exams page. There, right side you see, you will have a link given there for register for free GK content. There you will get. Agar mail mila to chhodna nahi. Mail kariye info@timeforeducation.com. Hum log zarur aapko mail ko reply karenge. SSC tier 1 series, please do that all. Webinar, correct. We'll do that, Dilip. Definitely we'll do. SSC tier 1 also, I'll take a session. Megha is saying thank you. Thank you so much. So, hope this session is helpful to all of you. Try to implement to the extent possible. Yogi is saying thank you. Thank you, Yogi. And maybe we'll be coming up more of these sessions. So, maybe 2 weeks down the line, we'll do English preparation. Agar most of you are asking for SSC tier 1 also. See, if possible next week or uske baad hum log zarur SSC tier 1 also, we'll take it up. We'll do that. And we'll do one more if you want an IBPS also, we'll do that. Okay, we'll stop here. Thank you, Preeta. Thank you, Shipra. Thank you. Thank you so much. We'll stop here. Then. Stay home. Stay safe. Don't go outside. Informative session. Thank you, Anjali. Reference book for geometry part. Oh, time material, Swati. Are your previous Kiran publication books are more than sufficient, Swati. Alina Rose Thomas. Thank you. Akhilesh. Thank you. Chandra, thank you all, and I wish you all in physical classes. Hope we meet very soon in physical classes also. Apurva saying thank you. Thank you, Apurva. Okay, friends, we'll meet next week with another session. Till then, we'll stop. Okay, thank you. Good night. Take very good care of yourselves. Don't go outside. Please don't waste your time. Please prepare. Please prepare. I want all of you to crack the bank exam or SAT exam in the next 1 year. All the best.